The 600-kilowatt solar plant developed by Germany firm Engie Equatorial Energy was commissioned by Energy and Mineral Development Minister Ruth Nankabirwa. One of the biggest hopes among the fishing community on this island is the utilization of the fishing plant.
We can even fish. Today we come back with our fish, we put on ice, we look for a market tomorrow. We need not to hurry, because when we were lacking ice, immediately you land, you look for a market because it is going to be rotten. But now when there is ice, it can stay there till we look for a better market.
Fishermen are also optimistic of utilizing the 3-ton drying machine for Lake Victoria sardine, locally known as Mokene.
Before the coming of this system, the locals used the nets they used to fish. They used the nets they used to fish, then they actually pour the raw mukene there, which is actually causes contamination because of the small stones which enters the gill part of the fish.
They have brought to us a drying machine for mukene, of which if we are going to work with them, our mukene is going to get another market which would not be locally, because we would take it to outside areas for a better market than the local markets we are having here.
Off-grid solutions such as this are some of the initiatives the government is pursuing to electrify areas, especially far-flung distances from the main grid. According to the Ministry of Energy Permanent Secretary Irene Batebe, Uganda's electrification rates currently stand at 57%, with off-grid solar systems contributing 38%. Energy and Mineral Development Minister Ruth Nankabirwa urged residents to desist it from vandalizing the installed equipment, as they stand to directly lose out.
Transformers, and please, 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 these transformers are yours. Don't tamper with them. Don't even come near. Don't come near a transformer. What do you want from me? You want to repair it or what? Hatari. Don't come near a transformer.
Similar projects have been developed in different areas whose connection hopes to the national grid seem distant, like Lamo, Bunjako Island in Pigi District, and Kiwumo in Mukono District. The plant that was developed by German firm Engie Energy shall sell the power to consumers at 1,432 shillings per unit over a 20-year concession period. This can be considered high in comparison with the 747 shillings that on the grid consumers served by companies like Umeme pay for each unit.
A little bit of a hassle, Honorable Minister, because like what Ricardo was talking about, the bankability of the project, the ability of the project to recover the funds that have been invested. That was a contestation, but God gracious, the regulator and the developer were able to agree on the price of electricity that the residents or the people of Lolwe will be paying for this particular electricity from this area.
Up to 3,783 connections, both domestic and commercial, have so far been made at the island against a projected target of 15,000 consumers. Story by Benon Ojambo for the news at Dolwe Island.